had prepared an introduction for my sermon this morning, but because of the events yesterday, I decided not to do it. So we're going to have just Bible here. So we, and a lot of Bible texts, because this commandment is full of lessons for us. So please, let us turn our Bibles to Book of Exodus. That is our text, verse chapter 20, verse 3 to 17. You shall have no other gods before me. That's the Ten Commandments. You shall not make for yourself an idol in the form of anything in heaven above, on earth beneath, on the water below. You shall not bow down to them or worship them. For I, the Lord your God, am a jealous God, punishing the children for the sin of the fathers to the third and fourth generation of those who hate me, but showing love to a thousand generations of those who love me and keep my commandments. You shall not misuse the name of the Lord your God, for the Lord will not hold anyone guiltless who misuses his name. Remember the Sabbath day by keeping it holy. 6 days you shall labor and do all your work, but the 7 day is a Sabbath to the Lord your God. On it you shall not do any work, neither you nor your son or daughter, nor your manservant or maidservant, nor your animals, nor the alien within your gates. For in 6 days the Lord made the heaven and earth, the sea and all that is in them, but he rested on the 7 day. Therefore the Lord blessed the 7 day and made it holy. Honor your father and your mother, so that you may live long in the land the Lord your God is giving you. You shall not murder, you shall not commit adultery, you shall not steal, you shall not give false testimony against your neighbor, you shall not covet your neighbor's house, you shall not covet your neighbor's wife, or his manservant or maidservant, his ox or donkey, or anything that belongs to your neighbor. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let us pray. Father, help us to understand your word. We pray that your spirit will help us during this time, that your word may sink in our minds and our hearts, and you may not only learn but apply the word in our lives. We pray in the name of Jesus. Amen. That is the fifth commandment. That is the fifth reason to take the Ten Commandments out of the church. And the fifth reason is, I gobierno, soy contra. I don't know if you get it, but if I have the translation. That is the government. I am against. That is the attitude that we have. And this is a phrase very well known in the Latin America. I gobierno, soy contra. Because we don't trust our government at all. They're there just to make money and get rich, and the rest of the people, they don't care about it. So there is that attitude. But before we start with this commandment, about the fifth commandment, we need to learn about the division between the commandments. It's very important for us to learn. And maybe this is the reason why we had two tablets in the Ten Commandments, because we finished the parts of the commandment that is related to God. So there are commandments related to God, and there are commandments related to people, what we should or should not do to people. And the first four is about God, what we should do about God, or what we should not do. So this is the division, the commandment toward God and the commandment toward people. And Jesus was very clear. He summarized the whole thing. If you read Matthew 22, 35 to 40, we see that one of them, an expert of the law, tested him with this question. Teacher, which is the greatest commandment in the law? Jesus replied, love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind. This is the first and greatest commandment. And the second is like it, love your neighbor, yourself, as yourself. And all the law and the prophets hang on these two commandments. Love God, love your neighbor. And this is what we believe. This is what people believe, that we have two tablets. We have there the two tablets are one side. We have love God. You shall not have other gods. You shall not make for yourself an idol. You shall not misuse the name of the Lord. Remember the Sabbath. On the other side, we have the love your neighbor. What is that part? Honor your father and mother. You shall not murder, not not commit adultery, shall not steal, shall not give false testimony, you shall not covet your neighbor's house. So those are the two that we have. So today we're starting the other side, the side of the people, what we should do with people or what we should not do to people. So that is the fifth commandment. And that is the first commandment, the other side, on the other tablet. And this is what the Bible says. Exodus 20, 12 says, honor your father and mother so you may live long in the land the Lord your God is giving you. And then in Deuteronomy 5:16, Moses expanded a little bit. He said, honor your father and mother as the Lord your God has commanded you so that you may live long and that it may go well with you in the land the Lord your God is giving you. And we're going to see how hard it is to keep this commandment. Let's take a look. And it's very interesting because we need to understand that God here is talking about authority. He just came from the God commandment, and he's starting with the people commandment. And the first thing, God is the ultimate authority. Now he's talking about the other authorities that he put in our lives while we're here. And the parents represent those authorities. So let's take a look at the scope of the fifth commandment, the scope. And Paul in Romans 13, 1, he says something very interesting and very tough to swallow. Everyone, and he's talking to the church, everyone must submit himself to the governing authorities. Ouch. For there is no authority except that which God has established. The authorities that exist have been established by God. And it's good for us to remember that when Paul wrote those things, those emperors, the Roman emperors, they were evil in a way that we cannot even imagine. Sometimes we think that the mayor, the governor, the president, or president of other countries are evil. You cannot imagine how it was back then. Paul is saying this is that God established this way. So let's see the scope of this commandment. The first one is the parents. You right there, it's the parents. Children, obey your parents in everything, for this please the Lord. Parents is included in this commandment. It's not just the parents. This commandment applies to other areas, other people in our lives. Let's take a look. The parents is the first one. The second one is spiritual leaders. The Bible is very clear that the spiritual leaders need to be respected and obeyed. Look what Hebrews 13:11 tells us. Obey your leaders and submit to their authority. They keep watch over you as men who must give an account. Obey them so that their work will be a joy, not a burden, for that would be not a venture to you. And then 1 Timothy 5:17, Paul is talking to Timothy. He said, the elders will direct the affairs of the church where well are worthy of double honor, especially those whose work in preaching and teaching. So spiritual leaders are involved in the scope of this commandment. Not only that, this commandment goes a little bit further than that. And that is the tricky part for us sometimes. It involves the civil government. Civil leaders, teachers, boss, everyone that has authority over our lives are included here. Look what we have in 1 Peter 2:17. Show proper respect to everyone. Love the brotherhood of believers. Fear God. Honor the king. And Colossians 3:22 says, slaves, obey your earthly masters in everything, and do it not only when their eye is on you, and to win their favor, but with sincerity of heart and reverence for the Lord. And we don't have a slave this year, thank God. But it's the idea of respect of the boss, because they are the boss. They have that authority. So that is the scope. The scope is not just the parents. The scope goes from the parents, spiritual leaders, and civil leaders, government. So that's the scope. Now let's take a look at the demands. What this commandment demands from each one of us. The first thing that the commandment demands is honor. Honor. And the word here is make happy. That's the translation, literal translation. It means the parents are carry great weight in the lives of their children. Honor your father and mother so that you may live long in the land that the Lord your God is giving you. Honor. The second demand is respect, consideration, not only for the parents, but then expand to elderly people, to all the other authorities. That's the idea, that to treat with respect and have consideration for parents, elderly people, and other leaders. Look what Leviticus 19:3 says. This is God talking. Each of you must respect your mother and father, and you must observe my Sabbath. I am the Lord your God. And Leviticus 19:32, rise in the presence of the aged. Show respect for the elderly and revere your God. I am the Lord. Do you remember the time that the teacher would come to the class and all the students would stand up? Do you remember when the director would come in, or another teacher would come in, and everybody would stand up? It's biblical. We respect. We respect and have consideration. So respect is a demand from this commandment. Not only respect, obedience, obey. The word does not mean translation. It means to do what you were told. Of course, this is related with when you are under their supervision. Like a little child, while they're a child, they're growing up, they have to obey, period. When they grow up and they have their own life, they still need to respect, but they don't need to obey all the time. But here, Colossians 3:20, Paul's talking to the children, said, children, obey your parents in everything, for this pleases the Lord. Obey. Another demand, support, is included here. Support. It's interesting because people in the time of Jesus, they created a tradition that they didn't want to give the money for the elderly fathers or mother, and they said, well, we're going to dedicate this to the Lord. So I don't need to give to my mom, I don't need to support my mom or my dad. And Jesus said, look, this is wrong. You're breaking the law. Look what Jesus said. For God said, honor your father and mother, and anyone who curses his father or mother must be put to death. This is Jesus' talk. But you say that if a man says to his father or mother, whatever help you might otherwise have received from me is a gift devoted to God. He's not to honor his father with it. Thus you nullify the word of God for the sake of your tradition. Support. Support is included here. Take care of our parents. Grandparents to help. And there is another demand, or not a demand, but something that we need to understand here in those demands. That these are supposed to be to the good and to the bad. It doesn't matter. The commandment doesn't say, honor your good father and your good mother. Honor your good teacher. Honor your good president or your good governor or your good pastor or your good elder or your good... It doesn't say that. You say honor. Honor your father and your mother. So you may live long in the land that the Lord your God is giving you. Honor. The good and the bad. Honor. Respect. Have consideration. And sometimes obey. And there is only one exception about obeying on those demands. The only exception is if they ask you to break God's law. That's the only exception. Look what God said in Ezekiel 20:18. I said to their children in the desert, do not follow the statutes of your fathers or keep their laws or defile yourselves with their idols. If they ask you to break the law, you're going to say, no, I'm sorry, I cannot do that. But they're going to say with respect, I cannot do that. And you're going to suffer the consequence. If you say that to the government, you say that to the teacher, you're going to say, I'm not going to do it. You need to be ready to disobey and suffer the consequences. This is what Daniel did. He said, I'm not going to do it. He suffered the consequence. God was there to help him, but sometimes not. So those are the demands. Now let's see that there's a challenge for us in this commandment. Let me share with you a few challenges for the fifth commandment. There have been many, but I want to share just two of them. The first one, the first challenge is the inclination that there is a desire in our heart to be the first. Every one of us, we want to be the first. We want to be the most important. We want to be the king and the queen. And that is a trouble for us because we don't want anybody else above us. Some of us don't want even God to be above us. But we don't want anybody else telling us what to do. The Bible called that folly. Proverbs 22:15 says, folly is bound up in the heart of a child, but the rod of discipline will drive it far from him. Sometimes you have to help the child that thinks that they are the king and the queen. And they want to do whatever they want to do and have all their wishes done. That's the desire. That's the challenge for this, the fifth commandment. There's another challenge. There is a rebellion inside of us against authority. There is a rebellion inside of each one of us against authority. We rebel against God. We rebel against our parents. We rebel against our boss. We rebel against the government. We rebel. There is something inside of us saying, do not do it. Do not obey. Do not listen to what they have to say. And Paul says that this would get worse in the end times. And sometimes I question, maybe we are right there. Look what Paul said in 2 Timothy 3:1-5. Says, but mark this, he said, there will be terrible times in the last days. People will be lovers of themselves, lovers of money, boastful, proud, abusive, disobedient to their parents, ungrateful, unholy, without love, unforgiving, slanderous, without self-control, brutal, not lovers of the good, treacherous, rash, conceited, lovers of pleasure rather than lovers of God, having form of godliness but denying its power, have nothing to do with them. So when we come to this commandment, we need to learn something. There will be consequences. There will be consequences. And this commandment has two kinds of consequences, the good consequences and the bad ones. And we need to learn that as we close the message today. Let's take a look at the good consequences. There are good consequences. The first one is live long and well in the land. That's the first one. Look what Paul wrote about this commandment, Ephesians 6:1-3. He said, children, obey your parents in the Lord, for this is right. Honor your father and mother, which is the first commandment with a promise, that it may go well with you and that you may enjoy long life on earth. He's not saying that we're going to have a longevity. He's not talking about that. He said there is more chance for you to obey your parents to have more peace, less violence, better quality of life, better relationship. We're going to have that. So that is the first consequence. The second good consequence is that pleases God. Look what Paul wrote for Colossians 3:20. Said, children, obey your parents in everything, for this pleases the Lord. You do something, not only your parents, the government, the spiritual, you do those things, and that Jesus, God, we set promise from him. But there is bad consequence. Let's take a look at the bad consequence. So the scriptures are clear about that. The first one is darkness. You break this commandment, you're going to experience darkness, loss of vision. Proverbs 20:20 says, if a man curses his father or mother, his land will be snuffed out in pitch darkness. This is why some people, they have no clue about their lives, their destiny, where they're going, why they're doing those things. They have no clue. They don't have to actually struggle to see the purpose of their lives because of the way that they treated their parents. Darkness. The second bad consequence, curse. Deuteronomy 27:16 says, curse is the man who dishonors his father and his mother. Curse, the curse that comes from love. And sometimes we're paying, and we don't know why we don't know. We're paying because of what we did, how we treated our parents. And finally, there is one more consequence, death. Exodus 21:17 says, anyone who curses his father and mother must be put to death. Of course, we don't have that anymore. Can we imagine if we had that today? But there's consequences in our lives for things that we did to the leaders, the parents. And we have a harvest in our lives of things that we don't know why. But they are there. They are there because of our relationship with our parents. They are there because of that. As you can see, this commandment is, we're not keeping that commandment at all. We have a problem with leadership, with authority. We're seeing this on TV, we're seeing this in our lives. We have a problem with the spiritual life. We have a problem with our parents, grandparents. We have a problem. Don't honor, we don't respect. We don't have control over our children. They do not respect, obey their parents, their thoughts anymore. So I believe that I prove to you that yes, this commandment is out of the room. If we cannot obey, if we cannot believe, then better to remove. Honor for the father and mother. Spiritual leaders, civil government. That is the commandment. Let us bow our heads and let us pray. Father, this is so hard for us. And we ask you to bless us. We cannot do it for ourselves. We recognize the desire in our hearts to be the first, to be the most important. We recognize the rebellion in our hearts against authoritism. And we ask you to help us to honor our parents, to honor our leaders. Honor those that are older than us and respect them. We pray in the name of Jesus. Amen.